Welcome everybody along to our second session of the mini iMoot 16. And we've got Gareth Bernard presenting now on improving the user interface. And I'm sure all of you know Gareth. He's pretty much involved in almost all, well, I think you've done all the iMoots, I think. I can't remember. But yeah, Gareth's part of the furniture with the iMoot. And so Gareth, yeah, on behalf of yourself and the rest of the iMoot team, I'd like to thank you for presenting. And I'll hand it over to you. Thank you.
Hello, welcome. What I will do, guys, I'm just going to quickly turn off my webcam because bandwidth's not so great. And we'll get going. And I'm presenting about improving the user interface. Rather unpretentious early. Right, so welcome. Yeah, first slide. So this we're going to talk about a little bit of admin, introduction, go through bits about information about Moodle themes, but also about how they started off. I'm really going to look about where we've come from and where we're going to, and then perhaps please do get involved, talk about them. Well, I'm going to try and keep it as techie-less as possible for you, but if you want to ask techie questions, no problem. But please, if you're not techie, do not be scared. Okay, just a little bit of admin trademarks because I will be using bits and bobs from them. Usual. There. Right, this is me in full steampunk outfit. So, yeah, the Moodle user interface has changed over time, but has it changed radically? Not sure. Yeah, some people it has, some people it hasn't, but could it be good? Could it be bad? Could it be improved? And there's a little, that's what I do under there. Just give you a second to read that. So this is Steampunk Output, which I used recently for some of the volunteering that I do. And it was a good thing for Halloween. So I thought, oh, well, that's a really good thing to dress up with. So, and later on, I'm not really good at reading what's going on in the chat at the same time. So if you could kindly just note down what you, any questions you may have, please we'll answer them later on. Okay, Moodle 3.2 themes. The visualization, Moodle is and themes are the visualization of the visualization of the functionality. It helps us to do what we want to do in the real, in the virtual world. It's our way, it's interface, it's how we present ourselves. Like I got myself dressed in that. I could be in ordinary clothes, I could be in different clothes. And they have evolved. Three real key milestones. Before Moodle 2.0, there was just a certain way of doing things, there's loads of things, but they're all really based on one thing called base. And very bland. I even be cruel, they look like late 90s sort of websites and stuff. Not really good. So in Moodle 2.0, there was a key milestone that they changed the whole theme mechanism to make it really, really easy to use and to develop and make it the whole structure for other theme developers to start really innovating. That was one key milestone. Then next one was introducing the Bootstrap framework in 2.5, and that came out of some really good work by Gentrical Baz Brands, you may know, and David Scotsman, and also many others as well. And they had a contributed theme that was taken on board for, oh, that's really useful, good, was responsive, as in terms of if you expand and contract the screen and screen, and it would adapt, and you would no longer need a separate mobile theme because it would readapt for that, because there was one other one based upon jQuery UI and something else, jQuery Mobile, that was it at the time. It was, yeah, it was okay, but it wasn't brilliant. So that was another key milestone. We started using that in the clean thing, which we'll come across in a minute. Then another thing called Moustache came in Moodle 2.9, and that has really made sort of done a separation between how theme developers and how your theme works, and hopefully makes it easy for slightly non-developers to make a difference to it. Well, that sort of remains to be seen, but I think it is the next big main key milestone, and it certainly makes it easier for other theme developers to adapt what the core is. A lot of it is still really ingrained, and oh, you can't change that, and yeah, this over time will make it. Now the big question that's coming in Moodle 3.2 is a new, brand new thing called Booster, which is built upon, based upon Bootstrap version 4, which is the next one coming out. So it's the next great, hopefully wonderful Wizzo super duper thing, which will really maybe push the boundaries. But there's, yeah, question mark of that. So why, maybe do you ask yourselves, am I dressed like that? I'm holding my iPod going, no. So I'm dressed as sort of, you know, steampunk, and maybe perhaps in the, you know, 1900s Western sort of style. I'm trying to really express something there where clothing ourselves, we as a species haven't really evolved so much, but we're social animals. We still interact, but we interact with different technologies. If you look down at a big city, nobody's talking to each other or making conversations. They're all walking along with their mobiles in their hands, sort of oblivious to the world around them. So the technology has gone far faster than society, and maybe we're just changing it, the society as well. So does Moodle have that impact? Can Moodle change the same way? Can Moodle then empower us to then do something different? Can we get out and be more, still more social, or are we going to start to be a bit more blinkered? Do we need to change? There's a whole, yeah, range going there. So the clean theme came in yet, Moodle 2.5, built a proper top of the contributed Bootstrap theme that came, which actually was released all the way back up, like in Moodle 2.2. It is responsive. So as I said, you expand and contract, it adapts, the screen, screws the sizes. Lots, not to say there wasn't themes before that that did that and allowed that, but this is just makes it slightly easier. It's a framework, so it's only a starting point. So the clean theme is meant to be very, you know, straightforward. You can just use it out of the box. And it does have reusable components. So you see like a box there. There's the same style for the buttons. There's the same style for the navigation bar you see at the top, outlining, that sort of thing. Make just better. So instead of, you know, making more, have, oh, I'll make one of those things and another thing and another thing. And you end up with loads and loads and loads of different components. That you only use once, here you can use it again. So like going from the old completely build something from scratch to actually using nuts and bolts and standardization. And that is still having an impact on Moodle. It's not there yet, and it could definitely be improved so that we have a consistent style, so that you change one thing one way, says, oh, I'll change this on the universe, and you know it's going to be brilliant, it's going to work everywhere. That needs to still happen. So, but when it came out, it really started to engage people. There's got a real buzz, started people thinking about the layout. It has a grid system. So hopefully, guys, you can see my pointer going over. There's 12 actual possible columns in a grid, and these can be laid out. So there, between there and there is 9, and across there is 3. And then within there, because that's 9 broken down the screen, that one, the other way around, that one will be 4, and that one will be across there will be 8, and that's my collapsed topics in the middle doing its own thing. So it is integrated. It does bring into modernization. So it made me think of bringing it into how we should be looking at it. Really, really updated the look of Moodle, and perhaps made it more attractive to people who are seeing these sort of things on other websites, thinking, yeah, it's bringing it now more modernization. So, the more theme. Similar to clean, arrived in Moodle 2.7, it is designed to easily change the look and feel of the user interface. Now, previously, even essential and other themes and the ones I was making at the time, or starting to make, really tricky. You can do certain things, but you couldn't do others. And without getting too technical, more introduced the technology underneath it to make it easier for theme developers to give you the functionality that you wanted without you having to be technical. So using a different way of creating the styles, the CSS, to make it more dynamic. In fact, my shoelace and another one, son of shoelace or daughter of shoelace, called Canvas Theme, which I worked with David Bogner on and still do, uses the same technology. just a bit more flexible. And you see there's a slightly different look and feel there. You can see the navigation bars change. You can upload the logo. You can do lots of other different things with it a little bit more. And I think I do see sort of questions on the themes forum about it, that people are using it really in real life just as a, for their actual Moodle site itself without needing to go to a contributed theme. So then came, or then comes, Boost. This is a brand new Moodle theme. It's still under development, so there's still bits of it that we're new, not quite sure. It is upon the new forthcoming Bootstrap framework version 4, which hopefully brand new technology, and they've really evolved things, how that works and how it's structured to what they've learned from all the way from 2 to 3 to 4. And in fact, all the most existing themes and clean use version 2. So it's really getting quite outdated and not supported. So this is going to make a huge, hopeful leap into the future. And there you can see it looks quite different, Grays. It has a thing called presets, which I'll show you in a little minute, which allows you just click on a button, change the whole look and feel of it. It is, as I say, still under development. I believe Damon Wise is still making a lot of effort to change the navigation. There you click cloud site administration, it comes up with another one. You see a lot of the blocks are being removed on the left hand side. You've just got buttons. They're really having a whole idea about the whole user interface. Later on, if you've got your own test server, demo server, I've got links for my previous presentations that allow you to do that. Do try out Moodle 3.2. Don't worry if it doesn't work so well, because it's still under development, but it's worth giving it a whirl and a little play and stuff. So presets, as I mentioned earlier. So there's default Platley paper, readable, looking at the screen there, and some of initial settings, and that just changes the look and feel of it. So you get a whole different look by just pressing one button, rather than with some other themes, and I do actually include Essential in this, but you have to tinker with all loads and loads of different settings, and it's not one, oh, I changed the whole look of it. I know with Essential that there's alternative colours and you can change that, but this changes other things as well, I think, and even maybe possibly layout or just whole elements of it. So you get a completely different look by just by clicking one button. Worth a good play there. So we're going to have to really, really see how that turns out when it finishes. I think actually Moodle 3.2 has been delayed because they're still working on that, it and other things as well. So coming back a little bit back in time, this is Bootstrap version 2, is my shoelace theme. I'm presenting it really because I'm really quite proud of it. I'm really happy with it. I've evolved it very recently. I took it on to as an idea, as a way to learn how to do things. I thought, oh, crumbs, I was inspired by Clean, I was inspired by Bootstrap, the original theme that Baz and David came out with. I wanted to keep it elegant. I wanted it to be minimal, different. I wanted it to reflect my style, which is very clean, elegant, non-cluttered. Not pattern, no pattern, you know, very, very a distinct style. So, and it was very rounded at the time. Now I did some analysis and looked at more modern websites, and everything seems to have gone a bit square. Square corners, very distinct colours, very distinct things, no more rounding going on at all. So I've redesigned it recently to be really, hopefully, more modern, more up to date, to evolve. And that's the whole thing with the user interface and our social life that and our social interactive and how we interact with the computer is the interface needs to change to adapt, even if the underlying functionality stays the same to allow us to do the same thing. We want to be comfortable with our environment. I don't know if you guys, if you, you know, every year you get a 7-year itch and you think, oh, I'm going to chuck out that old settee, I'm going to repaint that wall, even though it's still your own house, it's still the old bricks and mortar and stuff like that, or cabin or wherever, or whatever you're living in. But you still want to get bored with it and you just want to change and make it more modern. Same things happened here. And this is freely available using the link there. And this is just for Moodle 3.1 and above now. I haven't bothered updating the previous versions because the effort. And there is, I have created a lovely overview on YouTube. We use the link there. One key thing, which the next screen will show you, I've done. I took a look at WordPress, and that is beautiful. Under the bonnet, really, really lovely admin interface. And they have layouts, and they have things. So you can just click a button, it changes the whole thing. So I learned about the moustache, which we'll come on to later. Saw an idea, saw a glimpse, thought, I can use that to do something like WordPress. Radical. And that's what I've done with layouts. So previously, you fixed to, I've got three columns, that's how my page looks like. I've got two columns, that's not how my page looks like. Boom. You are fixed. I've changed all that. So now you can, via these little radio buttons, click and change the layout of loads of different elements of Moodle. So you can change your course layout. If you want it just with blocks at the bottom, it'll be there. One column on the left, one column on the right, two columns with a column block on the bottom, and blocks left, right, top and bottom. You can have it. You just press it, click the red button, save it. It completely changes all that type. You do not need to write a single line of code, whereas previously you had to go and change PHP code. If that's scary. And that's what the user interface should be about. It should allow you to do some things really quite intuitive, and it's with the graphics I put there as well. And that's really its key selling point. It's free, by the way. So yeah, download it, try it out, and yeah, make it good. And there's also a new one, another one for the front page. So you can see, I want the slide or the marketing spots above or below. You can swap those around. So I'm really trying to innovate here with how it all works. Thanks, Trish. I really, as you can tell, please. And also please visit that video. I'll explain it a little bit more detail, and you can see things really change it. But I wanted to give people a choice. Some people like it left, right, up, down, give you the ability to style the site the way you want to. I don't intend to take it much further at the moment, unless I think of, that'd be really, really cool to do. But you can change the colors and other bits and bobs as well. So that gives you some ideas of how things could be, how they are, and also hopefully where they've been. So discussion. Pick some, we've got some old news. So there's some giraffes there talking away, and that's a picture of the Tornado steam engine. So old is still running new, even though it's a brand new steam engine that's only built a few years ago. It represents the past. So what do you like? What would you like to do now? What you want to do in the future? How could we improve the Moodle experience? Perhaps is there one thing that you could think of that even you could get someone to do, or persuade the Users User Association to say, Moodle HQ, we really, really need this. This would be the absolute best thing you can do to improve Moodle and bring it into even further into the modern world. Because at the moment, this is my personal opinion, I feel it's starting to lose its way. It's got a lot of baggage that needs stripping out, rebuilding, refactoring, taking out, make it less cluttered and stick to do, because there seems to be a lot of big competitors out there, and it's going to be a really tight market. And we love Moodle, so we really want to take care of it and hopefully bring it on. So has anybody got some thoughts, please, they'd like to share in the chat? I'll pick up your microphone.
Gareth?
Yep.
One thing that I've sort of seen now and again and seems to be mentioned in comments here now is the future of blocks. And my view is that the more it goes towards Bootstrap, the less blocks are going to fit in with that image. Mm-hmm. What are your views on that? Where do you think blocks are going?
At the moment, there's always been docking, and there's another excellent one called the square format, where it puts them into squares. At the moment, I think that blocks are, and I haven't seen anything that's good as a good replacement. So even though, yeah, they look old hat, there's nothing says, oh, this is the new best way to make do what they need to do, if that makes sense. There seems to be a lot of information on the screen. They need to be hidden away. Maybe I think it's the whole underlying interface which needs to change, that needs to reduce all the duplication and all the clutter. Then there'd be a reason for blocks to not exist. But at the moment, you need blocks because that's the way that the underlying system needs to present itself. And there's nothing I've really seen that I think, well, that would replace blocks overnight. So it's not that they're bad. Yes, we can replace them. We must get rid of them. It's that they're there and there's nothing really, really that can replace them at the moment. So I hope that answers your question. Right. So Trish said, so I like blocks, but if we could layer more like a Photoshop style, then it'd make them more seamless. So, oh, I wonder what you mean. Like, so Photoshop, so layers, like in a paint program. So they appear and reappear. So you say, right, okay. Yeah, I think I know what you mean. Almost like three-dimensional. Going back, so they blend. So maybe a bit more opaque, but maybe they only appear when you need them to appear. Crumbs. I'm trying to think. There was something that Sun Microsystems did years and years and years ago. I think it was called Glassfish, which is a 3D environment before they got taken over by Oracle. I think it was Glassfish. I'll see if I can find that.
Gareth, what I'm sort of saying is if we could, you know how your banner at the top, it's very... there's a cutoff line, you can't get that overlooking, you know, style, so that it can sort of blend into the areas below. I understand, I like the blocks and like them separate, but if they were layers that you could sort of put over the top so they look like they blend as one photo, but they're not, like you do in a Word document where you get an image and you can make it sit over the top of the text and you can blend it in, it's still a separate component on its own, but you can merge everything more so it looks less blocky. At the end of the day, it looks like a complete page.
Yeah, sorry, I just had a moment on those guys. Or like a Rolodex or something where it was all in one area, that when you hovered over it, it would then appear. That sort of thing.
Yeah, just so that you can... the only thing I can think of is I use Photoshop a lot and take many different images and layers. And you can put them over the top, and in the end, when you outlay the picture, it looks like it's one picture.
Right.
So the user experience is one picture, but it's actually many components just working together, and it's just they look like they are one, but they blend on the edges. So your imagery could be more blended, that's all.
Okay. Yeah, so like they sort of merge into one until you need to access them.
I think the areas like the buttons and things like that would still say separate. It's just having the... so visually you'd still see each of the components that are interactive as separate on the page. But it's sort of like allowing that bleeding into the white space of the page so that they look like they merge, but they don't. Like if you look at your giraffes there, it's a very clean edge. Mm-hmm. If I took a Photoshop, I could, you know, have a tapered edge on the giraffes that would make it look like it is more blended with your text block.
Right. I always talk about a thing called feathering.
Yeah, almost like that. So, and if I had a logo that had a swell down the bottom of it, and I wanted to just overlap that on the start of my page, I could. So it's not just, you don't get the square banner.
Ah.
You're getting so very, that modern look. That's all.
Well, yeah. So almost more seamless.
Yes. So
yeah.
Even though they're separate components, it looks more in that modern look of a web page where it's
got
blended.
Yeah.
You could make it into a piece of artwork if you want, but blend it through, you know, but all the components still work separately in terms of programming. You know, you still got your blocks, so you click over there. It's more just in line with modern web design, so that you can have that blended edges. That's all.
Yeah, no, I see. Brilliant. Yeah, no, I see now what you're talking about. So it's less distinct that they're blocks and separate, but they're all more part of one of the same thing.
Yes, it could be much more visually appealing to people who are in that really high-end, you know, media thing, because that's the only component that I find hard when I sell Moodle is getting that very modern look that some of our senior executives want, you know, the edgy look. And I understand and appreciate the functionality of the blocks, but if we could have the look more seamless, the user doesn't need to know their blocks, and it could allow that creation of a more edgy look that is easier to sell to the more image-driven
people. Thank you. Yeah, really good. I think I've got some actual ideas. I might be able to do something with shoelace for that fairly quickly.
Can I jump in for a second? Because one of my concerns in a lot of schools is very similar to what Trish is saying, but I think we say it in kind of different ways. I found that a lot of the schools that I work with, they want to custom design the layout to make it along the lines of what you're saying with feathering things out and making it more graphically pleasing. They're frustrated that even when we find a theme, we can't necessarily get it to look the way they want it to look for their schools. I've had a lot of people ask me if there was any way to do something similar to Page Cloud, where it's really modular, where you can change the design on the fly. And the other issue is 508 compliance, because a lot of times when we create the Moodle sites, when we throw it through a 508 compliance checker, it's not compliant. So we have to sit there and try and play with all these different components to make it compliant. So those are two things, you know, trying to make the districts want it to look more like their website. So we have to find a theme that looks similar to their website, but, you know, finding the color codes, and sometimes it's not easy when you have that page that has all the codes that you put them on. It would almost be easier, like with the Google Chrome extension, where you could click on an area and find out what the color code is and almost change it there. Does that make sense?
Yeah, it does. So almost like a more click and change interface?
I'm sorry, I missed what you just said.
So like a more click and change interface?
Yeah, if you use the Chrome extension, there's the Chrome browser, there's an extension called Color Picker Eyedropper. And basically, you can just click on that extension and click on any area of the page, and it gives you the color code for that page. And I've had people say to me, I wish I could just click on an area and type the color code, because I know what I want to change, but I don't know what it's called in that back page. So, like, for instance, looking at the page right here, if I was able to click on the word improving and type a color code for blue, anything that would have been in that color at the top of the page would automatically be changed to blue.
Yeah.
Without
Brilliant.
Having to try and do it on the back end, it would be much easier for them design element-wise, which is what holds a lot of people back.
Yeah, thank you. Brilliant, Carrie. I mean, yeah, I can see where. Sorry, I'll just mute you because of feedback. Thank you. Yeah, I mean, so instead of thinking how to relate between, that's on the page. What on earth is that sending? Oh, ouch. So looking at the time, Well, I'm just going to answer a few questions, and perhaps we'll come back to this. It's a good discussion in a minute. So, looking back, art blocks and in that right order. Tom Wilson asks, what tools do we have to conduct usability tests on users? Good questions. That one, I know there's accessibility ones, and you can use that for checking the page. There's also tools for actually doing testing the whole interface. Usability tests, to be honest, I don't know. I think it's a case of not sure what tools are out there. I don't have all my themes and what I think they should look like. And also I get loads of wonderful feedback from the community, which is really, really great. And that helps me to say, oh, no, it'd be good if it worked that way. And I look at other things. But perhaps as some people, other people can say, oh, this is what we use for usability tests. I think Moodle now employing a person to look at the whole user interface and will then be a more specialist in that. So hopefully that will be more on there. If anybody else does know, please put it in the chat, please put it on the forum on the course that associates this presentation. My notes, activity picker could be done much better, like the WP widget model. I don't know. Oh yes, widgets. Yeah, I see what you mean. So in terms of picking up, drag and drop, move it there, put it that's where it should be. Thank you. Right, thank you guys. What we're going to do is, yes, and that has actually, Mike just put WordPress, a decent user interface model, and we're in separate. There is really good scope, I feel, of Moodle have a back end, which is for admins and takes all the clutter away from the front end. And that is something really we need as a community to aspire to. And it has been mentioned before, but it's still worth definitely mentioning again. So guys, going to move on. Next one. So things you can do at the moment, like of course editors, is custom CSS. So if you want to quickly change a theme and actually come back to Carrie's comment of, oh, what's that? There, I've clicked on Moodle 3.2, I've hit the selector, I've pressed F12 and found out what that is. And I've written some CSS, and most things will have a custom CSS box, and you're able to write it. Now, it's not brilliant. This is still a little bit techy, but if you want to have a play, it's a really, really good way of doing it and changing your theme rather rapidly. I'm not going to go any more depth in this presentation because there's a great one I did in iMoot 2015 there. And if you need your own test server to have a play with, there's also my own Moodle presentation from iMoot 2014, links in that the references afterwards. But that's also what's great. Most things, yeah, you can customize it in a very straightforward way, very quick way, just with a little bit of code. But I think, again, coming back to some earlier points, that does need to be improved. Moustache. You can see me pointing to my moustache there. Brand new thing, a little bit technical, but it's there is defining a template. So remember when you're young and you had stencils and you drew things out, and you maybe drew flow charts, or you drew little spaces, or you had a spiral graph, or made spirals and pretty patterns. Same sort of thing. It makes the underlying code look less messy. And coming back to an earlier point that I had, is also great for theme developers to start changing huge swathes of Moodle without needing to you actually change them in the first place, rather than previously they couldn't. So it's simpler and it can be dynamic. That's a bit for my shoelace theme. So there on the screen I've got some markup and I've got some bits, which is the moustache bits, which is the dynamic bits. Previously that'd be really, really messy. So it's getting more sort of a plain language, easier for non-technical people to make changes. And hopefully that will make a really, really big difference in the future. But that's another step forward in improving our user interface. Okay, so those are the references. So if you want help, there's the themes forum, Moodle Bootstrap theme, the shoelace theme, my overview templates, read up on that, and also my own Moodle previous presentations. A little bit of challenge for you before we finish off with our come back to our discussion. So we've learned about how themes evolved in Moodle. We thought about how technology has evolved, and whereas we as a society maybe hasn't caught up for that, or it hasn't even impacted on society, and maybe we don't quite understand that yet and how we interact with technology. We've looked at different themes. We've looked about and thought about how we can improve the Moodle interface experience with feathering, with color dropper, with changing things directly, with widgets. We've thought even about what we need usability tests to get more information and feedback. We've looked at how we can quickly customize it. And we've also started to look at Boost and the new theme technology, which hopefully will make our experience of Moodle better. And hopefully we can feedback to how that's being developed in the future with Moodle 3.2 and beyond. Please do use this to discover what the themes are presented. Try a test installation, because the great thing about is not just reading about it, listening about it, interacting about it, is to develop it yourself, to not sort of develop it yourself, but to play, have a good play, enjoy it. And also discuss and consider with the people around you, what would you like in your Moodle experience? Put that on the Things Forum, give out the ideas there. Some of the ideas I'll take away, I'll go and do that, and great, that'll only take me 15 minutes, an hour or something like that, and I'll make it happen. Something that's long, different question. So thank you. So if there's any questions, like that, and we can carry on chatting until Shane kicks us off. So we've come back to that discussion earlier about good, bad, and if we've got to chuck some ideas and just have some thoughts. Thank you. So guys, please further put any more questions, any more ideas, and we can chat to discuss about it and ask you anything you like. So thank you. So Shane asks, given that you need some coding knowledge to edit them, is that another level of complexity for little game? I think it's less complexity, Shane. Looking at it, previously you'd have to learn bits of PHP and also HTML. Now it's actually, even though you need some coding knowledge, you need less coding knowledge than you did previously. So you only need to change a few little things, and only really need to know about HTML and know what components you can put on that page, rather than knowing bits of PHP as well. But I think actually pragmatically time will tell. It's more an impact on, we'll be able to gradually change loads of things and customize the look for what we want.
Hey Gareth, Shane here. So thanks for that. Hey, I thought, while there's no more questions happening going through, I'll just formally thank you for your time and for another great presentation and for being part of iMoot yet again. So thanks for that.